Hello and welcome to another episode of Business Class. I am your host Shantanu Prakash, and today we have a very special guest on the show, Vikram Chandra, who is one of India's best known TV news journalists. He was also the founder of NDTV.com and now is the founder of Editorji. Editorji is revolutionizing the video content space in India. And Vikram, you talk about this as being snackable news, being very personalized, using artificial intelligence. So tell us about how did you think about and how did you visualize the concept of Editorji?
Thanks a lot, first of all, for having me on the show. And in brief, you know, so while I'm the founder of Editorji, I'm the CEO of NDTV.com and other things, I'd spent a lot of time in the TV news and other ecosystems. And that really gave me a realization of some of the basic problems that the whole video news industry is facing. Television news has got its problems. You're chasing, you're not getting subscription money. You have to get advertising. For advertising, you want to get TRPs, which means you have to chase TRPs. That's an issue with TV news. Digital video news, the user experience is not ideal. Because if you want to get 30 different pieces of news, to tap on 30 different tabs to get the news that you want is problematic. People don't do it that often. And also, you have to know that a piece of news exists before you go and tap on it. So for that reason, digital video works well if it's Netflix or, you know, Amazon Prime and you want to watch a serial. But for video news, it's not there. So people are getting video news, essentially social media. They'll get snippets of information. They'll see videos that somebody sent them. That's really how they're experiencing video news from the smartphone generation. That's not optimal because a lot of that news is fake. A lot of that is not authentic content. And almost by definition, it's coming to you from an echo chamber. So there was clearly a vacuum that I felt existed in the space of video news and information. Text is okay. Text, there are good solutions for. Other things, there are digital video, there's good solutions for. News, there are solutions for. But digital video news doesn't have a solution. There's a vacuum. So I said, let me try and build the solution.
Oh, fantastic. Very ambitious vision that you have. And I was going through the Editorji app, and it's fantastic. It's very slick, very easy to navigate. Some of the look and feel that we've used is very similar to what a digital native, someone who's living on his smartphone, is very used to. For example, the playlists come like Spotify. The recommendation engines for video are like Netflix. So was that something that was a conscious strategy that you're trying to target a certain kind of consumer? Which means that you're also not targeting a certain other kind of consumer.
So that's actually an excellent question. In our assessment, when you're trying to shift or introduce a new type of an ecosystem, you've got to do two things. You've got to have a native experience that for the natives of that new ecosystem is slick and perfect and beautiful and well-designed and does all the things that it is supposed to do. So there is the Editorji native experience, which you get when you download the Editorji app. Now you're in native Editorji territory. Yes, it's maybe for somebody who's used to watching television news or used to watch something, they say, kya hai? There's a bit of you have to figure it out. Oh, I tap this and it creates a news channel for me. And oh, I can swipe to go from story to story. You've got to figure that out. We don't think it's that difficult to figure it out, but you can figure it. You figure it out. That's the native experience. But at the same time, we are also very careful of having a second part of our strategy, which is working with all the existing players in the field and figuring out how we can plug into that. Because we think that we can complement them. So and we've tried that during the election. We played a very strong complementary role to many of the other players, platforms, which are in the market. And we think we work well in partnership.
So you speak about the fact that video news is broken. And Editorji has the new formula for success. But I noticed that there are several different pillars on which the Editorji platform is actually standing. So there's a new way of watching news. There's a new way of consuming news. You're also creating your own content. You're also aggregating. You're plugging into different partners. Do you think for a startup, because the conventional wisdom is that you got to do one thing and you got to do it very well. Aren't you doing too many things right now?
It's a good question. And I think The answer is no, for the simple reason. All that it means is we have set, and it took us a lot of time to conceptualize and build all of this. I mean, let's not forget that the team which was working on this collectively would probably have, I don't know, 300, 400 years of experience put together in television news and digital and other stuff. So it took us a lot of time to put it together. We are not necessarily trying to be hyper ambitious and think, oh, I have to get, like, let's get 10 million downloads here, get 500 this, all that. We know it'll take time. But when somebody comes and looks at it, you say, actually, these guys pretty much have the solutions to most of the problems, which means if you've got a complete solution for people, somebody coming just to the app, there's a solution. And it's a ready-made solution. If you're a partner who says, I want to get the answers to what I'm having. Yeah, we've got a solution to that. Oh, I'm a TV news channel. How do I use this? Yes, there's an answer to that also. I'm a distribution platform like Twitter or Facebook. Do you have a solution? Yes, we have a solution for that. We have all the answers. Now, we're not being crazy of saying we're going to go and dominate the entire industry or supplement or say that we have to be the only answer in 6 months, 12 months. It takes time to do that.
And you've
seen, so we are ambitious in our scope of what we can do, but we're being realistic when we are saying, okay, this is what we're going to do. Although, frankly, so far we are ahead of where we thought we would be at this stage. We are ahead of it. So, and the election was a big help in
that. So, when I looked at the numbers, you're already off to a fantastic start. And I believe that, election time...
Inshallah, touch wood. Yes,
absolutely. Good luck for that. And election time on Twitter, I believe that the number of video views that Editorji had was more than everybody else combined. Now, that sort of... And you have a million downloads on your native app. So that must be making you feel that you're already a rock star entrepreneur from being a rock star TV news journalist.
One thing which I've learned in this business is that nobody is a rock star anything, right? The market it's a tough, competitive world out there. Just because you're off to a good start, I mean, hey, we're so busy, watching World Cup cricket, you know how it is. You can get off to a flyer in the first six overs, and then two wickets fall, and suddenly you're saying, now what do I do?
But I'm sure you have your game plan worked out. But really, my question is about Vikram Chandra as an entrepreneur. So, fantastic run. You're very popular. Everybody in India who watches news knows you. But this
You'd
shift
be surprised.
To...
It's not as much as you may think it is. But
okay, I mean, everybody I know knows you as a TV journalist, right? But this switch to being a journalist to now being the founder of a company where you got to run the P&L, you got to answer to investors. So what sort of keeps you awake at night? Is this big issue about the media industry on monetization and profits? Do you also have a formula for that?
Actually, yes. The answer is we do. And that, frankly, is the single biggest part of what Editorji is going to offer. It's not out there right now. It's a thing that we are putting into development. So this is not the first time that I've had to worry about P&L. I was the CEO of NDTV.com and the CEO of the NDTV group. And I know the pain that the entire industry is feeling right now. What are we doing? For the media industry, the entire question of, we're doing a lot of work and, Google and Facebook are making all the money. You're aware of it. How do we monetize? How do we do it? How do we deal with the pressures of doing great content and find a way of monetizing it? That's the question that keeps every single media CEO awake, not just in India, but around the world. So obviously, when we are starting to do this, the real question which was there is, if we do A, B, C things correctly, is there eventually a path to better monetization? So today, what we are working on and what we are building is the answer to that. And as with everything else that we are doing, the answer for us is going to come again from the use of AI to disrupt. There's only X amount that I can talk about on that right now, but the things that we are building right now, and that's really when we think we will have the compelling story to tell, not just investors, but a compelling story to tell other partners. If we can help you monetize, now is it of interest to you?
That's probably going to be the real big answer that people are going to be watching Editorji very closely, at least in the media industry and the analysts.
We hope.
Yeah, sure. So Vikram, tell me, you've got a very interesting set of investors in your company. So there is Hindustan Times, which is traditional media house, so big in print, trying to do digital, and then you have a telecom company. So how does this marriage work?
It actually is working. You know, I can't tell you how blessed I feel that I have, you know, these two investors, because they came in, they bet on it, they said, all right, fine. And then they, and I have to say full credit to both Airtel and to HD, they said, you know, we're going to leave it to you to figure it out. They don't ask a question, they haven't interfered. It's like, as I'm saying, it's like best to have that. They just say, do it, keep track of it. We have full faith that you'll be able to do whatever you're doing. And that's it. And they're leaving us alone, right, to do what we're doing. It's not just that, of course, that with them, we also get the ability to jointly develop stuff. So it becomes an important testing ground. So during the elections, we worked very closely with Hindustan Times in doing all of our content was running on HindustanTimes.com, which I'm sure worked well for them. It worked well for us. We were very happy with that. And with Airtel, we were able to put together the world's largest digital-only election programming. And it's the world's largest, right? So we were running on Airtel TV. We were doing daily election shows. We did something like nearly, I think, 600 stories during the election cycle. And the counting day show, if you saw it, it was television scale. It was a television scale show running live on Airtel TV and running on Twitter, which was another strategic partner that we had, and a couple of others. So that really shows you that if you have that good marriage between, let's say, a telecom company and new generation content, you know, and technology plays, some of the things you can do are really surprising. Like, who would have thought that this many people would be watching the elections, not on a television channel, news channel, but are watching it on the Airtel TV app?
But that transition of people consuming content on their smartphones has already happened.
Right.
Right. And you are riding that wave.
Yes. And you're building for that particular experience. Because actually, if you look at the data, what you will find is that a lot of the people who are, in a sense, if you're consuming video on your mobile phone, what do you do if you're consuming news on your mobile phone? The statistics will surprise you. The vast majority of people will just watch a live television news channel. That's what they do. They go to a live television news channel and they're clapping on that and they're watching it. I mean, you ask Hotstar, you ask Airtel TV, Z5, ask any of the OTT players. What are people watching? How do people watch the news? They watch a live television news channel. And that's okay. I don't have any problem with that. But to me, that's a unsatisfactory solution. Because why would I, this is a digital format, your smartphone. Mm-hmm. You can personalize, you can localize, you can do targeting, you can do a lot of stuff. Yeah. Because I know this is the user with his mobile phone or her mobile phone in this location. You know the things you can do with that? Mm-hmm. Why are you taking all the disadvantages of a television screen or a television news broadcast and showing it to somebody on the mobile phone? Television news, by definition in India, is built for cable and satellite. Okay. It's a particular feed that is designed for the entire country. And they do a great job of what they're supposed to do. I mean, like Aaj Tak, whether it's Aaj Tak or Republic or NDTV, whoever they are, they're doing a great job of saying, okay, I'm a cable and news, cable and satellite channel. I'm doing a really good newscast, which the average person across the country will want. Is it customized and personalized for a viewer in Gorakhpur? No, obviously not. It can't be. Is it personalized and customized for a person sitting in Gurgaon? Is it customized and personalized for a viewer in Coimbatore? It can't be. So but a mobile-first video experience can be. And that's the difference.
Let me question you on this, right? So, you know, everybody today, most startups that you go to, they will use words like personalization, artificial intelligence, using big data and machine learning. But if you really look at what it boils down to, okay, it boils down to how you order the content, for example. Okay, you are providing, I believe, the two languages right now. Yeah. On the fly, you can switch languages. Okay, so
on the fly, we can switch between video, text, and audio, also depending on bandwidth.
So today's version of personalization, the 2019 story on that, is I'm going to give you this in a format that you can consume in a more convenient sort of manner. So if your consumer in Gorakhpur versus Gurgaon wants to do in Hindi, you can get in Hindi. The Gurgaon guy can get it in English. But it's really not different content. It's the same content. You produce 200 stories a day is the same story that somebody in Gorakhpur gets, somebody in Gurgaon gets. But do you think, so really where I'm heading to is, do you think going forward, this whole, the holy grail of personalization is going to play out in a different way?
Okay, so here's what my view in this is. Today, and this is what I think our core IP is, what we filed patents and others for also. Today, and don't take my word for it, try it out, right? If you try it out and play around with the Editorji app. So now I'm coming to the native experience. Yeah. Because obviously in native Editorji, which is on the Editorji app, is when all the AI and the personalization can really work. It won't work on a, today if you're watching Editorji content on YouTube or Facebook or whatever, then there's no real, that doesn't work. On native Editorji, on the Editorji app, when you press that playlist, the top button, press the playlist, and the AI executes and it builds a newscast for you. When you open that playlist and you look at it, for me, even today, after being doing it for 8 months, I get a sense of wonder as to what it is that AI is able to do these days. Because what that builds for me is not just, if you look at what AI algorithms actually personalize and give to people in most other formats, it says, okay, here are the 8 stories that you should see. And it'll club them together and say, tarak. Take it. Here are 8 stories. Now you will see a cricket match, a earthquake, cyclone hitting Gujarat, and 3 stories from Bollywood, all in one little jumble given to you. That's the way it works. Now, on the Editorji app, if you say view playlist, it has created a newscast for you. Headlines first, national stories, international stories, business stories, tech stories, lifestyle stories, showbiz stories, ordered for you. And depending on who you are and depending on your preferences and depending on what you do, it'll be a tailored fit. We will never say, if you say, I only want to watch Bollywood. You can set there, I only want to watch Bollywood. We'll still show you some headlines. Why? Because we think you should be informed. So it's a fit. We say news that fits you. It's like we're like a good tailor. So we look at you, if you say, I want to wear a suit, but I actually don't want a lapel. We say, nahi chalega. But yeah, if you want a gray suit or a blue suit, we will tailor it for you.
So you're also doing then sort of deep user profiling and getting to know your customers very well.
Yeah, it will happen. It will continue. There's other, I mean, I don't want to get into the weeds of how the, the cluster mapping is working and, you know, how we are doing it. So we're using lots of smart techniques to do it. But it's a fit that we are aiming for.
So Vikram, a lot of the sort of the old economy media companies who are big in television or print haven't been able to successfully make this transition. So what is it about the DNA of like a startup like Editorji that's different from a Hindustan Times or a Zee, for example?
I don't think it would be fair to say that they've never been able to make the transition. I mean, like you take companies like for example, NDTV did make the transition from television into digital very successfully. Times of India has made the transition from print into, television or digital very successfully. Hindustan Times is trying a lot of really exciting things as we go forward, including betting on things like us. So they've tried. I think one of the things that advantages that we have is we have no forks to protect, right? So for a Times of India, the fort is still, my God, my print revenue and the print ad is really important. And for Aaj Tak, it would be my television revenues that I'm getting in there. We have no forts to protect. So we have a very uncluttered mind. We're able to say it's a fresh, clean landscape. Let's try and find the answers. And we have the ability to be patient. We're not in a hurry. You know, we have the ability to be patient. We are well-funded. We can spend that time saying, no, we're going to build this. We're going to build it correctly. I'm under no pressure to report quarterly numbers and to therefore say, oh, what is my DAU on my native app as compared to working with strategics? We don't have that pressure.
No, that's fantastic. Gives you a lot of headroom to be able to think and do things.
To think long-term and to do the right things.
Do things your own way. Now, the interesting question is, in this world of convergence, right? You've done so much innovation in technology, file patents. And then you have reporters spread all across the country. I believe a team of more than 70 people who produce 200 stories a day.
They're not reporters. So we don't use reporters. We don't have reporters. We don't need reporters.
Okay. So what do you call them?
They are content creators.
So content creators. Yeah. All right. So how do you describe yourself? Are you a tech company? Are you a media company? Or are you something else, like a new category of company?
I think we're a new category of company. We're a hybrid company. We're certainly a tech company. Our name is Editorji Technologies.
Okay.
So we are first and foremost a tech company whose core DNA is using new technologies and using AI to a large extent to try and transform the industry. That's where the idea came from. Mm-hmm. Sundar Pichai, in an interview that I did with him, looking at me and saying, and I've given him full credit for it, right? He said that, I said, why do you think AI is going to be big? He said that the day people in existing industries are going to use their domain expertise to say, how can I use AI to disrupt my own industry? Or to transform my own industry.
Mm.
I think transform is a better word than disrupt. Disrupt is negative. Sure. Transform is positive. And we think it's a positive thing that we're trying to do, not a negative thing.
So Vikram, when you look
so
at
So we're a tech company, core DNA, but along the way, we have a very large media arm
using
also.
Tech expertise to transform the media industry. Right?
How are we doing? Yeah. How do we have 50 people
doing
200 stories a day? You ask any media company, how on earth are you doing 200 videos in a day?
So like lowest cost content producer in the world? Is that a good tag?
I don't know whether we are the lowest cost content creator, but we have the ability to do it. And now we are extending the on. Look at what Editorji did. And this is the one thing which I think we are entitled to boast about a little bit. Is look at what Editorji did during the elections.
Sure.
Look at the interviews we did. Look at the scale of our live television show. We had more interviews with politicians, the top politicians across the board. Then I think virtually any other person, TV channel.
But that's because of your network and how well you know them. So they will show up for your show.
That's partly true. Yeah. That's partly true. But also 40 election stories a day. With a team of 50 people.
Absolutely.
Look at
fantastic.
Our costs. Look at our cost base for that.
So let's look at the organization, for example. So when you build a tech company, you know, there is a different way you organize yourself in terms of selecting people than a media company. So if you were to give me a peek into the way your org structure works. Okay, so who calls the shot? The software guys, the AI guys, or the content creators?
It's an interesting blend. You know, so we have a model which we do is that we work. Editorji is a company that's designed to work with partners.
Yeah.
Our core DNA as a company is work well with partners. And that's been the core from the start. So our tech, for example, is a partner, you know. OpenAI Technologies, Gaurav, Satish, been with me for 15 years when we were both all ex-NDTV. They've done the technology. We work with them very closely, right, as a partner. Design is done by a partner. AI is being done by a partner. So these are all partners feeding into the system. A lot of our core strength in-house is actually editorial, just because that's one of the things that we felt, okay, it's very tough to do this with a partner. So this we got in-house and we said, okay, we'll do it. So we work really, really well with partners. And the fact is, final call is at the end of the day, mine. Okay.
Yeah.
I call the final shots, but at the end of the day, it is designed to work very closely with a lot of people, stakeholders, sitting together and saying, this is what we need to do.
So final question, right? So a couple of years down the line, do you see Editorji being acquired by a large media house or a tech company? For example, a Facebook? Or do you feel that Editorji is going to continue his journey and become this really large sort of aggregator that every smartphone is going to have the Editorji app, like you have a Spotify or Apple Music, for example?
You know, that use of the word Spotify, and you've used it two or three times, and that's really interesting because actually that's one of the things that we're looking at very carefully, right?
Okay.
The playlist concept,
right.
The ability that Spotify had to transform the music industry.
Mm.
One of the things that we think we can do with digital video, and for very similar reasons.
Okay.
Television news is very similar to radio. You switch it on and then you leave it on, right? That's what television news is. Digital video, very similar to cassettes and CDs. Spotify and Apple Music and others change the ecosystem where you press something and AI executes and it builds you a nice music for what you want. Editorji has that capability today.
So first time it's happening in the news.
In digital video, news and information, it's the first time, right?
So if you go back and fast forward what Spotify did, millions of consumers paying a monthly subscription fee. Is that what you see for Editorji?
The final model, I really think, is still unclear right now. Okay. We know what we are trying to do. We mm-hmm. know what the vision is. Right. We know how we think it is going to work. But I'm very prepared to be flexible. Mm-hmm. Sometimes when you're too rigid to say, like for example, when we started off, we said, okay, let's only go with the native pure Editorji experience. Right. It may have been something that we thought about when I was first conceptualizing mm-hmm. it. Very soon in the process, we said, hang on, why are we doing that?
Yeah.
Actually, we should work very well with partners across the board for distribution, for example. So mm-hmm. today, we are designed to be plugged in, like Spotify's.
Yeah.
Spotify Connect, it plugs into speakers, it plugs into everything, right?
Right.
It plugs into that. Look at the way Editorji today is designed to be plugged into platform after platform. We are natively almost plugged into Twitter. We work so closely with Twitter mm-hmm. and everything. We're natively plugged in. You go into the Editorji, we just have a news channel, right, running on Twitter. We are plugged into Alexa in a manner that is, the election showed it, right? That how well we are plugged into things like Alexa. And we are designing to work on that. We are plugged into other things, you know, in a, Airtel obviously we are plugged into, right, in a very close manner. So we are designed to be plugged in to things.
Fantastic.
That might well be the future.
That's so wonderful. And good luck to you as you execute your vision. And thanks a lot, Vikram, for being here. And here's a media startup that's truly changing the way video news is consumed. So we'll be looking forward to getting more updates from Editorji as they execute their plan to transform, not disrupt, the media industry. Thank you.
Thank you so much.